employers or our customers or the people in our church congregation. It's not really my business, so I'll turn away from the wrongdoing. They're the ones who, through their complacency, are truly complicit in the wrongdoing. And then there are folks like you, the upstanders, the people who will stand up and say, no, we are not going to take it anymore. And we're seeing people standing up now, finally, across this beautiful country. People saying, we know we've been like sheep going to the slaughter. We're not going to put up with it anymore.
Hear, hear.
So thank you for being here today. Now, what do we have in this country because of the bystanders, the people who have accommodated? And I include in that class, and they're also the perpetrators, of course, the members of Congress, people from both of our dominant political parties who have profited, who have taken advantage of this corrupt political system with their hand out saying, well, we'll look the other way if you'll contribute to our campaigns, if you'll keep us in power, we will join you. We'll make it look like we're really out there representing the people, but believe us, we give you the wink and the nod. We are on your side and will allow you to continue to rape and pillage not only this country, but the entire world, impacting billions of people, so long as you'll keep us in power. The criminality that we've seen in this country has made it clear we truly have a two-tiered economic, political, and social system. And this isn't two tiers like Republicans on one side and Democrats on the other. They are with the very tiny, and we talk a lot about 1%, but it's even less than that, the 1,000th of a percent. Those people who have been calling the shots for years in this country. The people who have manipulated our system. The very richest, the very most powerful. And it really all started, if you look back, when Richard Nixon committed his crimes and he makes his deal with Gerald Ford to come in. And one of the first things Gerald Ford did was said, I'm going to pardon Richard Nixon and the people that were with him from their felonies that were committed so that they could stay in power. Corruption at its worst, at the highest level of government. And he said, remember what he said? We need to come together as a people, put the past behind us, and we need to look forward. Do those words sound familiar now with a president from the other party, President Obama, who we elected with the promise of hope and change, and yet we've seen more of the same. More of the same corruption, more of the same reinforcement of this idea that we really have two tiers in our justice system, two tiers in our economy. As soon as President Obama was elected, when he said so high-mindedly during his campaign that he believed in the rule of law, and if the laws were broken, people would be held to account. As soon as he's elected, in fact, it was before he was even sworn in, he said, well, you know, we need to pull everybody together, not look back, we need to look forward. So he was not only not going to seek accountability for war criminals, people who had committed the same kinds of crimes, international and domestic crimes, that were committed by so many that we brought to justice during the Nuremberg Tribunal. He not only has said no interest in holding them accountable under our laws for the unbelievable felonies they committed, the international crimes under the Geneva Conventions, under the Convention Against Torture, but he has resisted at every turn even an investigation into those crimes, the disclosure to the American people of what really most undemocratic way, saying he is in favor of hiding the truth from the American people and the world of the crimes that have been committed. It is shameful. We need to stand up as an American people and say that's not who we are. And we have to let those in the media know. You know, these people treat this as some kind of trivial matter, that we're not to be taken seriously, when all we're saying is that those Nuremberg principles, the United Nations Charter principles, are to apply our obligations that we undertook. You know, it was President Reagan. This is amazing when you go back and look at what was said. At the time the United States Senate ratified the Convention Against Torture, it was President Reagan who said, with the ratification of the Convention Against Torture, we're saying here today that as an international community, we will never again tolerate torture, and those who commit torture will be prosecuted for those crimes. And every signatory to the Convention Against Torture, including the United States, will prosecute those responsible for torture. That was a sacred undertaking that our nation committed to when we ratified the Convention Against Torture. And we as a people, people like you all over the United States now are saying, we insist that the rule of law be honored. We insist that the rule of law means that it's not just for us when we're brought to justice. It is to be applied to everybody, no matter how wealthy, no matter